Coffee drinkers, this may be the longest amount of time I've ever spent in bed consecutively. Maybe in my life, I was in the hospital when I was a kid. I think I was in bed for a few days, but definitely in my adult life, this is about as long as I think I've gone. Feeling better, but definitely not all the way, that's for sure. The report on the gig was good. I think I managed to switch off like the pain and the nausea for the most part. And there was some, you know, compliments and people enjoyed themselves. There was a lot of applause. So I'll take that as a good sign. And good to know I could get through it with, and pull it off, even though I was like super, super messed up. And Chelsea was there and was being awesome and has been awesome all day taking care of me, which I'm eternally grateful for. And today's vlog, wow, I literally haven't moved. I had to like... It was a stretch to get out of bed, grab the camera, and come back to bed. And I was going to do a Q&A. I thought, oh, this is perfect. I'm kind of immobilized here. I'll do a Q&A. I'll go down the comments on the vlog, pick out a few things. And I stopped at one. I was like, wow, well, that's actually a good thing to talk about. It was left by KIK1140 about a week ago on a vlog called Reverb Before or After Delay. I was trying to, you know, compare whether you put a reverb before or after the delay and what works best and how I do it and how I'm expect, whatever. That was where the comment was left. I'll link to that episode below if you want to check it out. But the comment left was, reverb should never be used with bass. It is not a guitar. So to me, there are a couple of things wrong with that statement, with that comment. Number one, it absolutely is a guitar. It's called a bass guitar for a reason. It's not a double bass. Not a contrabass, it is a bass guitar. So actually, your statement a little bit inaccurate there because it is actually a guitar. It's not a six-string guitar. It's not a lead guitar. It's not a rhythm guitar. It's a bass guitar. And besides that, the blanket statement of reverb should never be used on bass, that's pretty damning. That's pretty, like, that closes off a lot of opportunities. If you're going to say that something shouldn't be done, kind of for no reason, I'm going to go out on a limb and say you're not really supporting that. Like, if you think the reverb should never be used on a bass, give me a reason for that. Like, enlighten us all as to why you think reverb should never be used on a bass. I've used reverb on the bass, and I think it sounds amazing in certain contexts. Would I go and cover, you know, Otis Redding, like, I've been loving you too long with reverb on a bass? No. But in order to, like, find variation and find new things and kind of innovate with sounds and with soundscapes, reverb is awesome. Reverb is like one of the first things I go to when I'm trying to create new sounds and open things up, and especially when I'm like kind of working on ambient music. And it's not so much about, you know, reverb should never be used on the bass. That statement just kind of set me off thinking that it's really worth bearing in mind that we could all be a little bit more open-minded, me included, you know. And you know, I have something, you know, I really talk about pretty strongly about never slowing things down when you're transcribing them. Hey, that's the way I feel. Absolutely, 100%. And if you want to disagree with me, that's totally cool. If you have your own way and it works for you, okay, great. I just put forward the argument that you're perhaps doing yourself a little bit of a disservice by doing that, by slowing it down. Because, you know, as I've said, as Patatucci said in that clip that I put in that episode of the vlog, you know, music happens in real time. You don't get to walk over to the drummer or the piano player and say, hey, man, let's just stop the gig here. And can you play that for me again? You know, so, yeah, I talk strongly about certain things and how I think you shouldn't do them. But at the same time, I really try and offer like a context for that, you know, a framework of why I think that, and evidence of kind of experience driving that opinion, you know, to write a comment where reverb should never be used on the bass. That's a little, maybe a little short-sighted there, unless you're going to really support it somehow with some context and reasons why you feel that way. And of course, internet, YouTube, open forum, everyone is entitled to comment exactly how they like. That is why I have been blocking a few people recently, because I'm just getting sick of the monotony of some stupid comments. And I guess that's my prerogative, right? So everyone gets their chance. Everyone gets their fair chance. And then the old you are blocked thing can kind of kick in if I don't have the patience for it. And especially today being sick, and yesterday I really didn't have the patience for it. So kind of scooted a few people along on their way, just so as the channel didn't get kind of gummed up with nonsense. But yeah, every day I try and think, you know, because sometimes my reaction is, yeah, I don't want to do that. I don't think that's right. Don't do that. That's what I tell myself sometimes. And I try and tell myself a split second later, like, okay, why are you telling yourself that? And what's the worst thing that could happen if you actually tried the thing that you're telling yourself not to do? I've been super guilty of not being able to do that in the past. I think I've missed out on a bunch of things when I look back on life in general and music and my career and all those kind of things. And that's highly motivating now when it comes to trying to keep an open mind. And nobody is perfect. Me, you, everyone, nobody's perfect. Nobody can do that all the time. No one's like a Zen Buddhist, completely calm and all seeing, all hearing all the time. It just doesn't really exist on a large scale. So we have to just try and re-inject those thoughts and those ideas back into our process, I think. At least that's what I try and do. And that's why I'm sharing that with you. There was that one comment and I was like, There's something about that comment that I recognize in myself from 20 years ago, maybe. And there's something in that comment that was left about not using reverb on the bass that I've really tried to work on throughout my career. And why not share that with you? You know, maybe you're going through that same thing. Maybe you've experienced that, or maybe you're experiencing it right now. And just think about it. Maybe there's something that you don't even think is that significant that you might be saying that about right now. Maybe there's something you're like, no, absolutely no, I'm against that 100%. Especially if it's like artistic or music related or something in your learning process, you know. We all have opinions on stuff. We have political opinions, religious opinions, social opinions. We have all these kind of opinions. But maybe there's something that's, you know, politically neutral. Like your learning process for music. Maybe there's something, just a tiny thing that you might be closed off to. I know when I find those things that I'm closed off to, and when I open my mind to like, okay, what's the worst thing that can happen if I actually go ahead and do the thing I'm constantly telling myself not to? Wow, the amount of doors that open, the amount of opportunities that present themselves, you know, that could just be a simple practice routine thing, or something I'm telling myself that I'm way better at than I actually am, or just basic day-to-day train of thought. It's not earth-shatteringly innovating what I'm saying here, just something that comment brought up to me, something I figured I could sit here motionless, which is about all I can do today, and still make a vlog and talk to you guys about something that I do feel really, really passionately about, and something that I've struggled with a lot in the past. There's always that element, you know? I always want to find those things, you know, and sometimes the comments, which are awesome, don't stop leaving comments, guys. Sometimes those comments like that, a little one-line comment can trigger that and remind me like, oh yeah, I used to suck at that, you know, and I've really made an effort to change, and it's done wonders for me, for my psyche, for my sanity, for my career, for my life, for everything. So the more things I can come across like that, that they're inspired by comments you guys leave, the better. And sometimes I guess it's good to be a little bedridden once in a while, so I can sit here and ponder those things, and I can't run around and do a bunch of stuff and get caught up in LA or practicing, whatever it is. You know, I haven't even unpacked my bass out of the car from last night. Like, that's how I came in completely toasted and passed out. But well, I did the vlog. Somehow I did the vlog yesterday. And then I passed out and woke up super, super late, and I've been binge watching House of Cards with Chelsea all day. Yeah, there are definitely worse ways to be sick, I think. But I'm happy to be on the mend. I hope that's something that clicks with you, something you relate to maybe. Or maybe you know someone. That's the other thing. You know, if any of this stuff, that's the other thing I try and think about. If any of this stuff doesn't like immediately relate to me or to you when you hear something, I'm talking about when I hear something in an interview or a piece or a film or something, there's always someone around that it could possibly relate to. You know, I'm always forwarding things to people and talking to people, trying to figure out how to help people. So if that didn't resonate with you right now, today, if you're watching this and you're like, actually, you know, that's not me. Maybe you know someone who is, you know, and you don't even have to forward them this video, but maybe just you like convey that message and plant the seed in their head. And you know, the more we can get people kind of thinking openly, the better, I think. And I think that is all my brain has for today. I totally 100% should have got Chelsea to do today's vlog. I'm kind of bummed out about that. I'm glad that we got to watch a lot of House of Cards today, but I should definitely have asked her to do today's vlog. It would have probably been way more compelling. I think that's going to happen. We're going to Europe next week. I think she is going to do at least one of those vlogs while we're gone. She has to. It would be a lot of fun. And I'm sure it will be very, very insightful. Anyway, on that bombshell, today's vlog is done. And I will see you guys hopefully a little more adjusted and recovered and kind of roaming around and doing something a little more interesting than just laying here in bed tomorrow.